Hello students, welcome again in ARS tutorial, and today we are going to start further topic of class 9th, and the topic is fibers and sclerites. So in previous video we have discussed about the simple permanent tissue, in which we have discussed about parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. So the sclerenchyma is of two types, which I have already told you that it is of fibers and sclerites. So in this video we are going to discuss about the fibers and sclerites. So first of all we should know that what is fiber, what is their location and function. So here I have written so many important points which is very important for you, and you have to note down in your notes copy. So here you can see that fibers are elongated, narrow, tapering at both ends with lignified cell wall. So in this point you have seen that I have highlighted the important terms for you that you should know about them. Okay, so here I have written that narrow tapering. So what do you mean by tapering? Tapering means pointed at both ends. Here you can see that in the diagram the fibers are narrow tapering. This type of diagram or structure is known as tapering. Tapering at both ends. So in this diagram you can easily identify that the fibers are tapering at both ends. Okay, now the next point is appear polygonal in TS. Here I have written in the diagram TS and LS. Okay, so LS means longitudinal section and TS means transverse section. Longitudinal and transverse. Okay, so here I have written that fibers appear polygonal in transverse section. So here you can see in diagram that the structure is polygonal. Okay, next location you can see that it is found in the vascular tissue of roots, stem and leaves. Vascular tissue means xylem and phloem. Wherever vascular terms comes, you should understand that it is talking or discuss about the xylem and phloem. Vascular tissue, vascular bundle, these terms are related with xylem and phloem. And you are already knowing, I think, that xylem is responsible for the conduction of water and minerals from the root to the leaves. Whereas phloem is responsible for the conduction of food material from the leaves to all parts of the plants. In next video we will discuss about the complex permanent tissue, which you will understand that the types and function of xylem and phloem. Now the function of fibers are, it provide mechanical support to the plant, and also it present on the surface fiber on the surface of seed and fruits. Means ki fibers are present on the surface of seeds and fruits. There are very important function of fibers that it is used in ropes, mats, gunny bags, etc. Ropes जो आप देखते हैं रस्सियां बनती हैं, ठीक है, जूट जिसको आप हिंदी में बोलते हो, ठीक है, they are made up of fibers. Okay, mat चटाई भी बनती है, and gunny bags you have seen mostly nowadays you are seeing that gunny bags are made from the fibers, जो जूट के बैग बने होते हैं, that are known as gunny bags. Okay, so it is all about the fibers, and in diagram you can easily see that they have tapering end and polygonal in cross section, which I have written in the location and introduction. Okay, now the next one is sclerites. So sclerites are also known as stone cells, which I have already highlighted, you can see, and cell wall is highly lignified and stony. Means sclerites जो होते हैं वो stone cells, means they are hard in nature, that's why they are known as stone cells. We are comparing with stone, so you can imagine that why we are comparing with stone, because its structure becomes stone like after maturity. ओके. सो बिकम डेड ऑन मैच्योरिटी एंड फाउंड इन हार्ड सीड कोर, हार्ड शेल ऑफ नट्स, सेल ऑफ नट्स. यू कैन इमेजिन दैट द आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ नट्स आर मेड अप ऑफ स्कलरिट्स, और यू कैन सी द आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ कोकोनट आर मेड अप ऑफ स्कलरिट्स. ओके, एट लास्ट आई विल टोल्ड यू इन वुड ऑल्सो फॉर्म इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ बार्क ऑफ ट्रीज. सो द फंक्शन ऑफ स्कलरिट्स आर प्रोवाइड मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ रिजिडिटी टू द प्लांट्स. एंड इन डायग्राम यू कैन सी द डायग्राम ऑफ स्टोन सेल्स और यू कैन से स्कलरिट्स. सो वन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जाम्पल्स आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू इन विच यू कैन इजली अंडरस्टैंड द फाइबर्स एज वेल एज स्कलरिट्स. इन वन एग्जाम्पल बोथ टर्म्स आर कमिंग. कोकोनट्स जो नारियल होता है, कच्चा नारियल, जिसके ऊपर आप देखिए रेसे टाइप के रहते हैं, है ना, फाइबर्स. तो जो रेसे टाइप का है वो होता है फाइबर्स, ठीक है, और उसको जब आप रिमूव कर देते हैं तो उसके बाद एक हार्ड स्ट्रक्चर आता है ना, वो होता है स्कलरिट्स. सो कोकोनट रॉ, कच्चा जो कोकोनट होता है, वो एग्जाम्पल है किस चीज का, फाइबर्स एज वेल एज स्कलरिट्स. आफ्टर ब्रेकिंग डाउन द स्कलरिट्स यू फाइंड द फ्रूट. ओके, जब आप स्कलरिट या स्टोन सेल्स को ब्रेक कर देते हैं तब आपको फ्रूट जो उसके अंदर कोकोनट है वो मिलता है. सो देयर आर सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ स्कलरिट्स एज वेल एज फाइबर्स विच आई हैव रिटन इन द बोर्ड एंड there are so many important points of fibers and sclerite which are used in our daily life. So this is all about the fibers and sclerites. So further we are going to discuss about the protective tissue which is epidermis and cork. Okay, so here we are going to discuss the further types of tissues which is protective tissue in plants, and these are epidermis and cork. So in plants, after simple permanent tissue, parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma and their types, further protective tissue we are going to discuss, and it is of two types, epidermis and cork. So as name indicate, I have already told you, if you are not able to understand the meaning of any biological term, just try to break it. You have to break it. After that you can get easily the sense of the term, that what does it mean. So here you can see epidermis. So ep, you if you can break, ep means upon, dermis term related with derma, which means skin. Okay, means above the skin. So we are discussing about the plants. So in plants, above the skin, epidermis is present. Okay, so what does epidermis mean and what does it means, what is the main function of epidermis and cork? So epidermis and cork are very important tissue which are responsible for the production and development of trees. So here so many important points of epidermis and cork which I have written on board, you can easily see and understand. So the first point is that epidermis is formed of living cells arranged in a single layer. So you have to understand that epidermis is arranged in a single layer. So next point is in aerial parts, means in aerial parts of plants, it is covered with a waterproof or waxy covering, non-waxy. Okay, it is most important point, covering called cuticle. In plants, cuticle is covered with waterproof and non-waxy covering. Okay, also the cells of epidermis forms a continuous layer, but in leaves it has a small opening called stomata. So this point you can see in diagram, that epidermis is a continuous layer, or cells of epidermis is a continuous layer, but in leaves it has a small opening which is known as stomata. Okay, means aisa samajhiye ki ek continuous layer aap bana rahe hain, jaise ye bana hua hai cork, but continuous layer, to wahan pe koi opening nahi hai jahan aerial part mein epidermis present hai. Okay, but agar leaves mein present hai तो आपको पता है कि जो स्टोमेटा होता है वो लीव्स में प्रेजेंट है, ओके तो लीव्स में स्मॉल ओपनिंग है, वहां भी एपिडर्मिस है, बट एट द पोजिशन ऑफ स्टोमेटा इट हैज स्मॉल ओपनिंग सो दैट गैसियस एक्सचेंज टेक्स प्लेस, ओके इट अलाउज द गैसियस एक्सचेंज. आई थिंक यू आर नोइंग द फंक्शन ऑफ स्टोमेटा. सो हेयर दैट्स वाई आई हैव रिटन दिस पॉइंट दैट सेल्स फॉर्म कॉन्टिन्यूस लेयर बट इन लीव्स इट हैज स्मॉल ओपनिंग कॉल्ड स्टोमेटा. सो द फंक्शन ऑफ प्रोटेक्टिव टिश्यू इज इट प्रोटेक्ट अंडरलाइंग टिश्यू फ्रॉम द इंजरी केमिकल एंड इन्फेक्शन. सपोज इफ यू वेयर रेनकोट देन द रेनकोट विल प्रोटेक्ट यू फ्रॉम रेन. सेम एज द एपिडर्मिस प्रोटेक्ट द अंडरलाइंग टिश्यू ऑफ प्लांट्स फ्रॉम द मैकेनिकल इंजरी केमिकल्स एंड इन्फेक्शन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इट ऑल्सो प्रोटेक्ट अगेंस्ट वॉटर लॉस. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट वॉटर लॉस. And also it checks transpiration. Underlying tissue कोई check कर means की water loss से check करेगा means की अगर transpiration के through transpiration you are knowing that it is a process of loss of water in the form of vapor from the aerial parts of plant. So epidermis protect the plants against water loss and also it checks the transpiration rate. Okay. Now the next point is stomata in epidermis of leaves help in gaseous exchange during transpiration and photosynthesis process. ठीक है. So it protects the plants from the transpiration and gaseous exchange and photosynthesis. So in photosynthesis and transpiration, the rate of loss of water is maximum. So epidermis will protect the plants from this defect means you can say from loss of water. ठीक है. अगर water का loss हो रहा है ठीक है तो उसको कौन protect कर रहा है? Epidermis. Now the next one is cork. So cork are dead and closely packed cells without any intercellular spaces. Means in cork cell there are no intercellular space. Means कोई intercellular space present नहीं है. You can see in the diagram that in cork cell there is no intercellular space. Now the next point is cell wall are deposited with waterproof waxy substances which is known as suberin. It is very important point that you have to learn that suberin is a waterproof substance which cover the cell wall, okay, and it is impervious to water and air, means it does not allow the water and air to enter into the leaves. Okay, now the function of cork is it protect the plant from the infection, mechanical injury, etc. Same as the function of epidermis. Next point, bottle cork is derived from this plant, Quercus suber. Means bottle cork, you are knowing that it is derived from this plant, which I have written here. Now the last point is the cork is used in the manufacture of stoppers, sport goods, etc. So here, I have written the most important points regarding to epidermis as well as a cork. And in diagram, you can easily see that in cork cell, there is no intercellular space. Whereas in epidermis, stomata is present on the surface of leaves, which allow the exchange of gases during transpiration and photosynthesis. So here, this is all about the protective tissue, which is epidermis and cork. In next video, we will discuss about the complex permanent tissue, that is xylem and phloem. So this is all about the epidermis and cork. So thank you to all of you for watching us on Aristotelian.